worst edge on YouTube? You guys let me know.
Yeah.
All right, you might be wondering what I'm doing, kicking everything, but this blade's not even worn that much, and it's just a little short, so I have to hold it up at a steeper angle so that I can actually cut in, because the edge is so overgrown and thick that it's not getting deep enough to get down by the actual concrete. So I'm having to kick it out of the way. Yes, I can use a shovel, you don't need to tell me, but I'm the kind of person, when I'm doing a project, I'll kick something, get out of the way. I don't need to go get multiple tools to do one project. So when these blades get when these blades get short, you can get them all the way down to about right here, and you can still cut if you're weakly. You can just hold it at the right angle and you run with it and it's good. But when you're doing these cleanups, you wear them down real fast because they're rubbing against the concrete. So this is one of the things I don't like about metal blade versus a string trimmer, because when you're using a string trimmer and you get good at it, what you can just do is just tap that string out a little further and you keep cutting. So what you would do with the string trimmer is you cut a little bit on the edge here, you cut a little bit and work your way back. So you'll go down the edge and you'll kind of make an edge, a false edge, but you're able to keep it straight enough it looks like it's edge. Then you take it back a little further and a little further every week if you're just picking up this client. But if you're gonna do a full out cleanup and you're only gonna visit one time, the metal blade might be the way to go, but for me, I could always get the same results with a string trimmer. It's just getting good at whatever piece of equipment you're using. That's just my opinion on it. Let's go ahead and get back to it.
Let's go ahead and get this old bag of mulch out of here.
Not doing any good.
Everybody asks about snakes all the time. Do I see snakes? And then here's the thing. I rarely see snakes. And when I do, there's little garden snakes. Luckily, where we live, they say there's rattlesnakes, but I don't ever see them. So we have copperheads, water moccasins, and rattlesnakes, but everything else is all friendly. So I'm gonna put this guy, let's get him out of here. Let's go put him on the side of the house because he eats bugs. So let's get him out of the way. We want him somewhere he's not gonna get hurt because I'm gonna blow all the leaves out of there. Remember, he's a good guy, okay? So we'll just put him right down here in the leaves. Come on, dude. Yep, he'll take off and be safe there. So many people on here have told me the shovel's the best way to handle this, and I gotta tell you, you're dead wrong. The weed eater is. This is way more labor intensive. So I'm gonna knock it off with that, and I'll come back when I'm weed eating. I'm gonna weed eat that and clean it up, and you'll see how easy it is. Thank you. All right, enough playing around. I got a debris loader. I wanted to see. It does it, but not that good. Thank you.
Oh.
a handicap. 6 horsepower Craftsman. It's got the mulch kit underneath. Side discharge, so I might do side discharge on some of it. We'll see. But we're going to go ahead and try it out and see how it is. I know it smokes a little bit. Somebody tipped it over. If you tip these over, this has an air filter on this side, right? So if you tip it over, make sure that is the side that's up in the air. You know, if you got to get to the blades. If you do it the other way, you'll get oil down into your carburetor. And it'll, you know, get oil in the air filter. Jack it up. Anyways, let's go ahead and do this. I'd say that's a handicap. It's been a long time since I had a push mower. It doesn't even have self-propel, man. Oh, oil cap's off.
Thank you.
right, that looks pretty good, but we're not done just yet, man. We've got one last section. All right, one last touch. Let's go ahead and clean this up. There we go. That's the icing on the cake. All right, what do you think of that? That was a pretty good one. I gotta tell you, the shovel, a lot of work. We here would do it much better. So much better. Look nice and crisp and clean. Oh, we got one straggler, little hen bit. Oh, she got one. For the most part, all the grass looks awesome. Piece of trash, let's pick that up. We got a few things like this. This is some grass clippings. You can actually leave this on the lawn. It's not gonna look that bad. You leave it on the lawn and it will shred up on the next visit. And of course, stuff like this, you can either pick it up or again, shred it up on the next visit. This is all weeds, so I generally wouldn't. But if you wanna be real picky, like my first year, well, I would probably blow out the grass, fan it out for any of the little leaves and stuff like that that are left. And then from there, I would go through and mow it one more time. And by mowing it one more time, more trash, a little trash everywhere. By mowing it one more time, you're able to really fine tune it and make it look awesome. Of course, again, like I've said, when you got weeklies, you just come back and every week it'll get a little better and a little better, and consistently it'll look awesome. We went ahead and did the mulch, polished it up, fine tuned it. Again, if you'd like, let us know and we'll come wash the driveway. We'll see you in the next one. All right, if you haven't yet, give the video a thumbs up, like and subscribe for more tips and tricks and stuff like this. Hit the notification bell if you do want to see more and you want notifications. If not, either way, whatever it might be, see you in the next one.
Like and subscribe and watch Dad's video.